All right, the classic book, Like Water for Chocolate, is an important piece of Mexican literature, and it was popular in both Mexico as well as the United States. Well, now it's got a sequel, and Jordan's standing by with the author, Laura Esquivel, to learn more.
Yes, this is such a treat. Welcome, Ms. Esquivel, to our show, Good Day Sacramento. It is such a pleasure to have you on this morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Thank you.
And, you know, congratulations on all of your success. You know, your first publication of a Like Water for Chocolate happened over 30 years ago. And right now, you've got sort of part two. Tell us a little bit about this, because this part two, it is called Tita's Diary, is really focused on the main character and her journey. Does it take place 30 years later?
Well, no, no. The Tita's Diary, it's a book that Tita, the character of Like Water for Chocolate, she wrote. So I wrote the book as she was indeed writing the book, handwriting with letters, flowers, photographs, everything that you kept in a diary. So the story, because Like Water for Chocolate now is a trilogy. Mm-hmm. This is going to be only the second book. The third book takes place in the moment, in the actual moment, but with the protagonist, she needed to find that Tita's diary in order to understand and recover her own life. So Tita's diary is in Tita's diary, it comes 20 years hidden.
Wow.
Because in Like Water for Chocolate, I did I jumped in the last chapter 20 years. So those 20 years, they are here, narrated by Tita, and they are really emotional.
And it really is. And, you know, speaking of emotional, a lot of people, especially young girls who read, you know, your book 30 years ago or even to this day, have really connected to the characters there. And you really incorporate a lot of, I guess, cultural aspects into the book. And with this one as well, you're going to continue with, I guess, that journey and that success, right?
Yeah.
And it is so awesome.
Okay. That's the intention, to go back, not only to continue the story for only in a greater purposes, is because I think in this time, precisely in this time, we need to go back and find what stories, painful stories, have been repeating and repeating through the years, and we need to go back and say, I don't want to repeat this. Mm-hmm. I want to change it. And that's the story. We need to take all the stories, family stories, and work with them. And that that's why I'm writing this Tita's Diary.
Oh, it is that is beautiful, and you said it right there. You know, we have to hold on to the traditions, the memories, and learn from the past and just continue to move forward. So, Ms. Esquivel, we thank you for being with us. Tita's Diary is available on Amazon. It is a book that you can go out and read, and we're hoping that maybe it'll be turned into a movie very very soon, right? So we're crossing our fingers.
I sold the rights for a TV series.
Ah, very
wow.
Nice. Well, we'll get all the details from you, and we'll have you right back on when that goes there. We'll have the information on Tita's Diary for you to go out and start reading there and be inspired. So thank you so much, Ms. Esquivel, for being with us this morning. We wish you all the best.
Thank you.
All right, Courtney, over to you.